God promised to provide for us, irregardless of the situation. Our God is our provider, and He is able to provide for us in whatever circumstance we are in. He is eternally, infinite, almighty. He is the good, good Father. He is our good shepherd. Amen.
This is our place of providence and provision. We call this Goshen. This is where we live, the beautiful Darkin. Oh, I love this place. It's like Bicol. Parang probinsya lang. It's like a province. I love it. Thank you, Lord, for this beautiful nature, this beautiful place. You brought us in Goshen. This is our Goshen, God's place of protection and providence. Thank you, God, for your provision and protection. Glory to God. Friends and family, it's time for encouragement. I want to encourage you from the Word of God. The Word of God is our best encouragement. So, Genesis 45 verse 9 to 11. Joseph said, "Hurry and go up to my father and say to him, thus says your son Joseph, God has made me Lord of all Egypt. Come down to me, do not tarry. You shall dwell in the land of Goshen, and you shall be near to me, and your children's children, your flocks, and your herbs, and all that you have. There I will provide for you, less in your household, and all that you have come to poverty, for there are still 5 years of famine." So I want to repeat verse 10. Joseph invited his family. He wants them to come near to him. In Egypt, in Goshen, "You shall dwell in the land of Goshen, and you shall be near to me, and your children, your children's children, your flocks and your herbs, and all that you have." Brethren, in this time of crisis, of famine, you know, all over the world, all the nations of the world are all affected. There are more than 20 countries in the world who are locked down. And also more than 100 nations who were affected because of the COVID-19, and famine is in the land. People were affected because they cannot work, they lost job, so therefore there are many people already impoverished. They don't have money, they don't have food, they are pitiful. And we believers, we are also affected by that. But if we will trust in the Lord, He will give us a place of providence, a Goshen, and He will continue to protect us. And He will use a deliverer, a savior, who will provide for us. And our great deliverer and savior, like Joseph to his family, is the Lord Jesus Christ, to us, children of God and believers of the Lord Jesus Christ. So, pray for your Goshen. A Goshen is a locality, a special place of God's providence and provision in your life. Goshen is also a condition, not only a location, a locality, but a condition. Just like the condition of the world right now, because of this coronavirus, many people were discouraged, depressed, lonely, sad. But we believers, we need to check the condition of our hearts. What is the condition of your heart? Are you trusting God in spite of this lockdown, in spite of COVID-19? Are you drawing near to God, dwelling in His presence daily? Remember, Goshen means drawing near. So, we are encouraged to draw near. In this time, you need to search your hearts. If your heart is really longing, seeking God, He will fill your heart with joy, with love, with grace. So, Goshen is a condition, the condition of the heart. Goshen also is a place of preparation and purification. In this time of lockdown, the Lord obviously preparing our hearts, purifying the church, the bride. He is purifying the desire of our hearts. He wants us to love Him with all our heart, our soul, and our mind, and to trust Him and Him alone, because Jesus is coming back. He will come to judge the living and the dead. He will come first to take the bride, the church. He will rapture the church, and then He will come back again for the second coming to judge the living and the dead. So, are you preparing for the coming of the bridegroom, the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior? Are you preparing for the rapture? Are you preparing to meet Jesus? So, Goshen is a place of seclusion, preparation, and also purification. He's purifying our hearts. If we are willing, those who are not willing, of course, they will continue to reject God, resist God, and harden their hearts. The problem is, they will be judged when Jesus will come. And then last, Goshen is a temporary place. It's just a temporary place. Our situation right now is just temporary. Our place here in Dorking, UK, our Goshen, is just temporary. Someday, we will go to heaven. In Revelation chapter 21 and 22, the Apostle John says that there will be a new earth and a new heaven. And someday, one day, we will go to heaven. And in that place, in glory in heaven, in the presence of God, no more tears, no more pain, no more COVID-19, no more wars, no more earthquake, no more suffering. It's only eternal joy in the presence of God. Remember, Goshen is just a temporary place. Your suffering, your trials, your persecution, all of these evil things in this world are just temporary. Someday, we will go to heaven, an eternal place, an eternal joy, and we will enjoy our everlasting life in the presence of God. So God bless you today.
If this message encouraged you, please hit subscribe and make sure you turn on your notifications so that you'll be alerted anytime new content is released.